Hi, boys and girls. Today's lesson 16 starts off by introducing our new spelling words. Once again, there are 20 of them, and your test will be on Friday. So please, please, please keep this sheet, study it all week, practice it, give yourself a pretest on Thursday. All those things would be great. So we're going to start by going over worksheet 16.1 and review our spelling words. And as I'm looking at it, I see there's lots of proper nouns. I know they're proper nouns because they are capitalized, and proper nouns name something and are capitalized. So we have Madison, probably standing for President Madison. We have the word president, which we know is the leader of our country. Congress, one of our branches of government. British, which is what you would describe people from Great Britain are British. Washington, our country's capital. Impressment, we know that's when the British Navy was forcing our sailors to join their Navy. Cannon, death. Dolly, another capital proper noun, such as Dolly Madison. Merchants, paved. Hawks, probably dealing with the war hawks. Monarchy, which is the British form of government. Navy, battle, march, support, troops, painting, and then our tricky word is another proper noun, Ironsides, which was the nickname of the USS Constitution. So this week's spelling words is, they're all words that are dealing with the War of 1812. They're really not reviewing any new spelling that we've learned or anything like that. They're all words that are about the War of 1812. So we're familiar with them, but they're bigger, harder words, such as Washington. So a lot of these words you will have to break apart when you study them and think of Washington, okay? Same with impressment. So try to find ways to help you study these words to get ready for the test on Friday, because they are more difficult. I'm going to scroll ahead. We have worksheet 16.2, which is just a reread. We read the attack on Washington, D.C. on Friday. I'm going to do a close read with you now, but this is for you to reread it again for fluency and a stronger understanding of the attack on Washington, D.C. And then 16.3 is the one that you will be submitting. And it's just like what we've been doing. You have 5 spelling words. You need to put them in alphabetical order. Some of them you have to alphabetize to the second letter. So we have support, Congress, cannon, Madison, battle. Battle will go first because it starts with a B. Then we have Congress and cannon. So C-O, C-A, cannon would go first because A is before O. Then Congress and so on. And you will do that for each box. So this is what you will take a picture of and submit. But now we're going to get started on our close read, which is another reread of the attack on Washington, D.C., Chapter 5. I'll give you a minute. Flip there. If you need to, pause me and find it, and you could read with me, okay? So this is page 46 in your reader. Okay, Chapter 5, The Attack on Washington, D.C., In August of 1814, President Madison was upset. 2 years had passed. The war was still going on. The U.S. Army had won some battles, and it had lost some battles. And if you remember, a lot of our battles, we lost a lot of battles on land. We won a lot more battles at sea. So, the British had landed an army near Washington, D.C. British soldiers were marching. Madison hoped the U.S. Army would be able to stop them. At the time, Washington, D.C. was a young town. Some buildings had just been finished, such as the Capitol. Capitol with an O-L is a building. Capitol with an A-L is our nation's capital, like this city of Washington, D.C. Others were not finished yet. Still, it was an important place. It was where the U.S. Congress met to make laws. It was where the Supreme Court met. It was home to President Madison and his wife, Dolly. So there we have our 3 branches of government. Remember, branches are parts of our government. We are different than the monarchy's government out in Great Britain because we don't have just a king or queen. We have the U.S. Congress, the Supreme Court and the president that all make decisions for us, and they have to get along and agree. Here is a picture of the Capitol building in Washington, D.C., as it looked in 1810. So obviously, this was before the War of 1812. The President's House was a special house that had been constructed for the President. Today, it is called the White House. It was only about 10 years old at the time. It was home to President Madison and his wife, Dolly. So even though President George Washington, we know, was our first president of the United States, he was not the first president to live in the White House because it wasn't even constructed or built yet. So President Madison was our fourth one, and the White House had just been 10 years old, and he was living in it, but our first president did not live there. President Madison was aware that there was going to be a big battle outside the city. He planned to go support the troops, which means to help them. He ordered some soldiers to protect Mrs. Madison and the president's house. Then he jumped on his horse and rode off. That's very different than today's world and today's president. Back then, our presidents would go and support our troops. Today, you don't see our presidents riding out on a horse or even flying out in a helicopter to support our troops at battle. They support them in a different way. They don't support them by fighting alongside them. The battle outside the city did not go well. The US Army was beaten. People quickly found out about the defeat. The army had lost. The British were coming. People in the city panicked, which means they were freaking out. They were worried. They were trying to get out of there because they were afraid that the British were coming and were going to attack them next, and they wanted to get out of there. They grabbed their things and ran away. The roads were jammed with people and carts. Here is another painting of the president's house, and it was the home of the US president. We call this the White House. President Madison could not get back to the president's house. His wife Dolly was left there with servants and soldiers. The soldiers ran away. Mrs. Madison could not stay in the president's house. The British would be there soon. She had to flee, which means she had to run too. Mrs. Madison hoped to take as much with her as she could. But which things should she take? There were many fine things in the president's house. She loved the lamp that hung in one room, but there was no way she could take that. It was too heavy. She had a big closet of fancy dresses. She loved them too, but there were more important things for her to carry away. So even though she loved her dinner party, she loved to host, she loved to be fancy, she knew those weren't things that she should take. And here she is, a portrait of her. In the end, Mrs. Madison left most of her things behind. Instead, she carried away things that were important to the American people. She grabbed papers and letters. She stuffed as many of them as she could into a trunk. Mrs. Madison was ready to leave. Then she remembered one last thing. It was a painting of George Washington. There was no time to gently take it from its frame. She ordered the slaves and servants to cut out the painting. "It's done," said Dolly Madison. Then she ran out the door to safety. And here we have a photo of one of the servants cutting out the painting of George Washington, our first president. So she knew this was an important part of our history, and that's why she wanted to take it. And that is where we end today's story. So please work on worksheet 16.3 and take a picture of that, submit, reread 16.2, which is this story, to someone at home. And I will see you again tomorrow. Thanks, guys.